Hardware for creating and displaying. So essentially we're looking at hardware here for creating and displaying in multimedia systems. So firstly, we'll take a look at monitors. Okay, monitors are obviously a display device for its information process, and they display text, image, animation, and video. Okay, we have three classifications in the IPT course of monitors, but it has gotten a bit more dynamic lately with LED elements and retina displays. But with the IPT course, we look at these three main ones, and that's cathode ray tube, which are now obsolete. They were those monitors with the big back where the actual lighting would be pushed through and the gas capsules. Okay, but these days we still have liquid crystal displays, LCD, and plasma screen monitors. And they both have their advantages. One of them gives better brightness while the other one gives better blackness. Okay, but essentially that is how we view most of our multimedia, through a monitor. Okay, when it has visual elements such as especially video and animation. Okay, so moving on next then is obviously derives from this, and that's touch screens. Okay, because obviously a lot of interaction these days with multimedia devices is through touchscreen monitors. Okay, so they are, while they are monitors there and they're used for display, they're essentially collecting devices when they've got touchscreen functionality. Okay, mobile phones have them, tablets have them, game consoles have them, ATMs and information kiosks all have ways you can touch the screen, and obviously the user can interact with the system when it has that touchscreen. Okay, so here's an example of a mobile phone. Okay, and the whole thing about the mobile phone is its interface can change and allow the user to input in different ways into the phone. Okay, and obviously that led to the whole app boom when we had mobile phones that could have touch screens. Okay, popularized by the iPhone, but also Samsung and Android operating systems. Okay, that allowed the user to input into the system through a touch screen, monitor. Next, we'll look at digital projectors, and digital projectors are display once again, okay? Very similar to monitors, okay? But instead, we're displaying to larger audiences, okay? And so we can't have that fixed to a certain screen size. We actually have to go larger, something that physical monitors aren't capable of. Okay, so we usually project using a projector onto a large white panel, okay? If you're in your classrooms, you might see it that you've got... You might just be projecting on the whiteboard, but usually we use a large canvas, okay, and we project onto that. The monitor is placed back far enough so the image can be larger, but then the quality of the monitor will also show, you know, the brightness of colors and all that, and be able to be projected from further back. But essentially, every time you go to the movies, okay, the device there is a digital projector, okay, projecting onto that large canvas, okay. When your teacher teaches in the classroom, they're usually projecting onto the board with a digital projector. So essentially, a projector is able to project an image, video, animation, whatever, at a much larger size that is capable with most standard monitors, okay? And essentially, at a much better price point too, okay, than is possible. You can get some extremely large monitors, okay, but it's probably more cost-effective to get the digital projector. Moving on then, we'll go to sound, okay, and sound systems. And obviously here we're talking about the displaying of audio, okay? So these are the speakers, and they can display in stereo when we're using two speakers, or surround sound when we're using more than two speakers placed around the room, and such as, once again, at the cinema. Okay, obviously the one media type we haven't mentioned for both monitors and digital projectors was audio, because it's our speakers doing this. And when we start using multiple speakers to display different sounds as a part of our multimedia package, that's what gives us surround sound there. Okay, and the most simplest way to look at it is, you know, your simple, you know, what are they, the Beats speakers, okay, that you can use via Bluetooth with your mobile phone or link up to your computer, and that you can play your music through there, okay, for displaying audio. We've got to then talk about our storage mediums, and we're looking at storage and retrieving here, okay, and that's our CDs, our DVDs, our Blu-rays, and there was also videotape, which is now obsolete, okay, but these obviously were used for storing our multimedia systems for distribution, okay. Now it is very popular as well with streaming services and online stores that we can actually just get them directly from online, but people still prefer to get disc, because when you've got it on disc, it doesn't have to be installed always onto your system. It can stay on the disc, such as when you view a movie, okay, and that way you're not taking up your own system's storage on your hard drive or solid state drive. Instead, it stays stored on the disc, you insert the disc, and you view the multimedia that way. Okay, so essentially, it's all about discs there, okay, that we're talking for our physical storage mediums, and they're really the only types of ones we use. Now, there's also flash memory through SD cards and XD cards as well, and USBs, okay, but when we are talking about commercial distribution, it's mainly discs. Okay, and then finally is headsets. And now headsets, okay, is for collecting and displaying. And Obviously, I've got all the media types here, but it depends on the type of headset you're using. Okay, now there's the traditional headset. Okay, and that's essentially what I'm wearing right now. Okay, headphones with obviously a microphone attached for me to talk into. Okay, that allow me to interact based on audio. Okay, I can hear through the obviously speakers on my ears, and I can use the microphone at my mouth to actually put my audio into the system. But headsets have gone a bit further these days. Obviously, we are in the VR generation, virtual reality generation, where we have the actual goggles on the headset as well, displaying a fully virtual world in front of us. But also, there's what's known as AR, augmented reality. Okay, and I don't remember, know if you remember that Pokemon Go game from a few years ago, when you'd hold up your phone and it puts digital images on top of the real world. Okay, so we can still see the real world, okay, and then digital images are on top of it. Okay, so that's AR. And other systems that also make use of AR when putting digital images on top of the real are heads-up displays. Okay, when it gives us actual digital features around what we're actually looking at in the real world there. So headsets obviously are getting increasingly more popular for interactivity as well. Okay, so when we're doing our online gaming, whether it just be that we're speaking to the people we're playing with, but now with virtual reality too, where we can be fully immersed into the game's world. So I hope this video has given you an understanding of hardware for creating and displaying in multimedia systems, okay, and how they all display different types of medias, okay, when actually using them, but used in conjunction with one another as well in order to enhance the experience.